As you can guess, finding planets around other stars that are incredibly far from us is really, really difficult. We think of ourselves as so important on our tiny dot of a planet in the middle of an enormous galaxy that's part of hundreds of billions of galaxies. It's obviously the gold mine, right? If you could find evidence of life on other planets. Exoplanet science is opening minds to big questions, you know, perspective-changing questions. Are we alone in the universe? Is the solar system typical? It's hard to understand the Earth if you don't have a picture of what other planets are like. Studying the solar system, seeing the other planets in the solar system, has given us a lot of perspective on the Earth and, you know, how finely tuned some things have to be in order for life to exist. The discovery of planets actually orbiting other stars, that's changed the picture completely, right? We had only a single solar system as an example, and you just can't generalize from that. There's really only a handful of planets that we found by directly observing their light. It's just too hard to do with current technology, so we have to be more clever. We have to find indirect ways of finding them. And those methods basically rely around looking at the light that we get from the star rather than the planet. So for example, in the transit method, what you do is you look at a very large number of stars, thousands, hundreds of thousands of stars, knowing that there's some small chance that some of them will have their orbits aligned in just the right way, that the planets will actually cross in front of their star from our line of sight. Then when a planet crosses in front, that blocks some fraction of the surface of the star. So what you'll see is you'll see a dip in the intensity from the star. And once you see one, well, that's a candidate for a planet. And then you wait to see, you know, are these dips, are they happening periodically? If it was just some random event, they'll happen randomly. If they're planets, they'll happen periodically with the same period between dips. That is the method that today has been by far the most successful in finding planets, found thousands of planets around other stars. So now that we have a whole zoo of exoplanet systems, that allows us to ask the big questions. Is the solar system typical? Can we expect that what we see in our own solar system, life, everything else, is that something that's going to be common across the galaxy, or is there something very special about our solar system that makes it possible for us to exist? Those are like the big picture questions driving the field. My dreams of where this is going, where this could lead, is I have a four-year-old that loves looking at the sky, looking at the stars, looking at the planets. I would love to be able to point at a star and say, look, at that star, there's a planet, and that planet has life on it. Right? Maybe there are things there looking back at us. My name's Dan Tamayo. I'm a researcher in exoplanets in the solar system.
Thanks for watching, and be sure to subscribe so you don't miss the next video.